are the challenges being targeted in corruption, in the war against corruption? There are murmurs and indeed loud words that this fight against corruption in Kenya seems to be targeting the Kalenjin. On the face of it, it looks like it. But I think a deeper look at it will bring something different perhaps. Are the Kalenjin being targeted? Or are Kalenjins found in some of the most lucrative places? Corruption has been cited at the National Cereals and Produce Board. Billions of shillings lost. Kenya Power and Lighting Company, billions lost. Some Kalenjin at the head. Kenya Pipeline Company, KPC, billions lost. Another Kalenjin. And a host of other places, NHIF and so on and so forth. So one might ask, from one side, are Kalenjins being targeted? Somebody could say yes. On the other side, somebody might ask, why are they found in these lucrative places? And this takes you back to why Senator Keter was perhaps removed from parliament by William Ruto to become minister in charge of energy. Energy has some of the most lucrative prestatals. And agriculture, traditionally associated again with the URP wing of Jubilee, has lucrative prestatals, especially the National Cereals and Produce Board, a cash cow. So I think, instead of asking whether the Kalenjin are being targeted, Kenyans should be asking, why do we have so many of these Kalenjins in these powerful prestatals? How did they end there? Almost exclusively. Was it to balance off in a situation where the TNA wing of Jubilee was also having other powerful prestatals like the KRA, powerful ministries, like infrastructure? Is it? Was it to balance? And therefore, I think the chicken are coming home to roost, where the TNA wing, composed of people from Mount Kenya, have some of the most lucrative prestatals, most lucrative ministries. And the URP wing is also having some of the most lucrative prestatals and ministries. And therefore, as the chicken come home to roost, we could witness a lot of those. The only thing somebody could argue, then why are we not getting things from the other side? Maybe their time is coming. This must be a wake-up call to Kenyans and to our leaders to stop being tribal in appointments. Let's see the face of Kenya in appointments. Because as things are today, and this is not sustainable, because for those of us who love this country, we know some of these things are not sustainable. You cannot build a country where only one or two communities have the best of everything. That is not sustainable in the long run. And I hope this is going to be one of the benefits from the handshake. Going forward, we must balance appointments in this country so that if we hear there was a scandal, it will be Aluya there, Agriama there, Atulukana there. But these scandals are about Kalenjin, because the Kalenjins are in those sectors that are lucrative, where it's very easy to spill oil in quotes and say you've lost billions. Where it's possible to buy air and say cereals has a lot of maize. So we must balance public appointments. Follow the constitution. Have the face of Kenya in all these public appointments, especially the lucrative appointments. I don't subscribe to the idea that hata matumbo ni nyama, maharagwe ni mboga, hata omena ni samaki, so that the rest can have everything. No, let's have the lucrative things shared equally among Kenyans. Let me hear somebody from Turkana is head of the Kenya Pipeline Company.